Morning.
Morning.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
How's everybody doing today?
Good.
If you don't mind, I would like to open with a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day that you have given us. Thank you for the Sabbath. I thank you for this congregation and the people that we have met in this church, Lord.
Amen.
That you have brought us to this church, that we could know your truth, Lord. And I pray that you continue to speak truth through all of us, and that you will use me, and it not be my words, not man's words be spoken today, but it'll be you. And you'll put me aside and just use me as an instrument to speak your words. And I pray that everyone leave today with a blessing, and your will be done. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so when Miss Cox gave me this message to speak, she gave me the title is always accepted. So I thought I would look up what accepted means so we can all be on the right page. So accepted in the dictionary says generally believed or recognized to be valid or correct, to consent or receive. So now that we know what accepted means, we should know what the opposite means. And here's some antonyms: to deny, reject, or refuse. And when I was thinking of acceptance, a certain story came into mind. And if you'll turn to Luke 15:11, you can find that story.
Amen.
And we'll get right into it. Say amen when you're there. Starting with verse 11. Then he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land. There was a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. So when we leave God and we face hardships in our lives, we will begin to, like he said, he began to be in want. So now he sees this want for God, so he found what he needed. He needed to accept God, he found wanting. So now we know that we need his acceptance. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into the fields to feed swine, and he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. But he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me one of your hired servants. And he arose and came to his father, but when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I've sinned against heaven and in your sight, and am no longer worthy to be called your son. So, a part of acceptance is asking for forgiveness, and that's what the son does here. He comes back to the father, and God will always accept those who repent and turn to him. And see, the father was always there for him. He accepted him when he was in his house, the father accepted him when he left his house. And as we'll see in a moment, he'll accept them when he returns to his to the house. The father never leaves. We're the ones who leave. And God's always accepting us, but we have to accept him.
Amen.
He's always waiting for us to come back and repent. And you see, we try to clean up and say, we have to become servants. You know, But we're a friend of God. We don't have to be servants.
Amen.
He gives us more than we deserve. And as we keep reading, we'll find out he got more than he deserved.
Amen.
The father said to his servant, "Bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and sandals on his feet, and bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." And they began to be merry. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. So he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, "Your brother has come, and because he has received him safe and sound, your father has killed the fatted calf." But he was angry and would not go. Therefore his father came out and pleaded with him. So he answered and said to his father, "Lo, these many years I have been serving you. I never transgressed your commandment at any time, and yet you never gave me a young goat that I might make merry with my friends. But as soon as a son of yours came, who has devoured your livelihood with harlots, you killed the fatted calf for him." And he said to him, "Son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. It was right that we should make merry and be glad, for your brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found."
Amen.
So we don't have to do. See, you got the brother that strayed away, and you have the brother that stayed. They both get the same thing. You can. I'm not saying you should stray away from God, but if you do, God is loving and He's just to forgive you of your sins, and He's always there to accept you. You see, when you get, say you're getting married, if you love someone and they don't love you, then you're probably not going to get married. But see, God is the one loving us, and He's always loved us, but we can't go to heaven unless we accept Him. He's always accepting us, but He's waiting for us to accept Him too. We both have to do our part.
Amen. Amen.
Another thing is He wants you to come as you are, but He doesn't want you to stay as you are. He wants to change your life completely. And Malachi 3:7 says, "Even from the days of your fathers, ye have gone astray from my decrees and have not kept them. Return to me, and I will return to you, says the Lord Almighty." As we see in the verse in Luke, He says he was way off, and his father saw him and had compassion and ran to him. You know, he saw us and came to us. He was always there for us. He's waiting for us to come down. We're the ones straight. So if anyone has strayed from the Lord, this is an appeal to return to Him. He is waiting with open arms, like the father in the prodigal son's story. And if you stay, then continue to bear with Him every day.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.